the elders are saying, we are not going to participate in that primary. As a matter of fact, the state chairman of the APC, Anthony Mujeezwa, said, whatever happens today in the name of primaries is a nullity because it's illegal. Well, these are just issues that have been in the front burner, and all of this issue will definitely shape the Edo 2020 governorship election. Let me welcome a panelist. Harrison Izeko is a member of Oredo Local Government Legislative Arm. Many thanks for joining us on the program.
Thank you for having me.
Solomon Ijogbe, former state chairman, National Youth Council of Nigeria, is also a civil society activist. Many thanks for joining us on the program.
Thank you very much.
Okay, let me begin with Harrison. Yeah, the latest, perhaps the most current, is the fact that there will be a primary today in the APC, but underlining that is the fact that the state governor and his deputy and a host of others have now joined the PDP. What does this imply for Edo 2020?
Well, let me say it's quite unfortunate that a party that people labored, who contributed to make sure that we change the narrative from what it used to be. And when our comrade governor was coming into power, those of us from the civil society, we gave him the support because we knew that he have this idea of fighting Godfather and those who do not want to allow the country to run the way it's supposed to be, or the state thereafter. And the man came aboard. We all labored to make sure, even then I was not in politics, but from our angle, we gave him the maximum support. He won. He became a governor. He went to court, became a governor. He did the second term, and he handed over to Obaseki. I would have expected that the structure we have built must continue. First, you talked about Godfather, that reason you stopped it. You came to Edo to tell us that you have stopped Godfather in Edo state. Never again. So many prominent Edo persons were stepped on, insulted, dealt with. He told us we have retired our name and the rest of others. And we're surprised that the man you brought into power, telling us that this man was the best for the job, that you have done him, but you said something about this on social media everywhere. You gave your word, you even swear in the name of God for this man, that this man is the best. Suddenly, from nowhere, you allow some persons to begin to raise issues. The man had his game plan in governance. The man has said, no, government must not continue the way it used to be.
Okay.
That we cannot continue to release a domain for so few persons. We cannot allow the strong men to take over our society. We cannot allow Admiral to continue in the state. And because of this, so many persons were angry. And they now went to begin to land team of the National Chamber who refused to call these people together and look at the issues and say that as well we resolve it. Up to now as we speak, Adesanya Oshemole, I have not been able to tell the people what Godwin Obaseki did to him, that he was fighting him. And they went further to now screen a man that you are sworn with God, that these certificates, that they were real, that they were okay. You now screen him out with impunity. And you went on to tell Nigerians, Edo people, that you are the Appeal Court of APC, you are the Supreme Court of APC. You can imagine the way people are to get power to themselves. It is not so much power. And you push the man. Don't worry, you have a choice. That is life. And the man saw it, okay, this is the best way. Let me come in and get a shot. And now the man appointed it with the major opposition party in the state. As to speak, there is no word in those states that the EPM APC have a war secretary. They don't have. The secretary is existing, is a secretariat that is being managed, that we're loyal to the governor. Now the man have moved to the major political party. We are waiting, let the election come. And those people will speak.
Okay.
The people, the pensioners, the people, don't go to the street in Benin. They are telling you nowhere. Anywhere we go, anywhere you go, we'll go with you.
Okay.
Because it's injustice.
Okay.
It is criminal. You cannot even explain it. The issue is that I just ask them today, what is the problem? They cannot explain.
All right, let me pause you there, Izeko. Solomon, let me bring you in here. What has played out? Is it in any way tantamount to betrayal?
Very well. The Duke, you know, I would have expected my brother to have spoken to the issues, but let me leave that. It's not to do name dropping. But in any case, you ask the question, is the action so far tantamount to betrayal? Of course, To whom much is given, much is expected. Until 2016, I do not think that some persons were known politically in Edo State politics. Within the Edo State political space, some names were not at all known. And then, from nowhere, the gods helped you to crack your palm kernel. And it's a common knowledge that such persons should have taken up the toga of humility. I do not, just like my brother had mentioned, I'm yet to hear where, how they have said they are national party chairman. Because I hear they say Godfather, Godfather, Godfather. I need to understand, because I'm still asking, maybe before the end of this program, I will hear what made him the Godfather. Because I know when Adams came into government, then he met a house that was populated by a supposed opposition party to him then. And then his complaint was clear that in an attempt to approve budget for him, he was summoned to the leader's house. Contracts, budgets, sums were reduced, some were padded, and he was asked to agree to it as it cannot be passed. These were some of the things we heard. They were direct. These accusations were not hidden. But so far, so good. We've had Godfather, Godfather, and people like us are asking, what are the things that makes you say he's a Godfather? Does he have a commissioner in your cabinet? Does he have SSAs in your cabinet? Is he the one owning your SSD or your deputy? You understand? Has he influenced any projects? Is he truncating your projects? Is he holding your resources from the national? You know, don't forget, while Adams was fighting Godfather, he was making it clear that even his allocation from the federal, because he was on the opposition here, were being, you know, truncated, that his activities were being trampled upon, you know, owing to the fact that he was in the opposition and that the federal government then was the ruling party and he was not in that party then. So, point I'm making is that we got to know clearly the definitions of the Godfatherism and Godfather agreement. But here, we have had a situation where somebody said, Godfather, Godfather. Of course, there is no way you do not have issues. Even in your family, there will be little skirmishes. Some of your kids will feel like you prefer Godo to him or her. And sometimes, it's the main thing within family. And it occurs to that this and the tongue, they quarrel, but they still live together. So when you talk of the inner spirit, it's a main thing. Not about the family, but the team, they are asking for me. And today, in the public, before Mr. Adonio Prosper, with some of you, but they were a chance. Put that aside, Mr. Adonio purchased for 22 million and from APC. But the PDP, 21 million and 43 million. And this is money. Now you add it to about 8 million. I'm not sure, you know, you can say that's a very smooth. So it's still a bad name in your black community. For me, when you make accusations, because for whom? You know, it's a bonus of proof is on whom blacks. You understand? For some of us, we are not being able to be clear on what makes you say what that is. Let me tell you, the young party does not have leaders. I mean, that will take you back to governor's decap to the People's Democratic Party. It's first, one of his standards of comment is that I am a leader of the People's Democratic Party.
No, institution here.
You know when you were talking.
All right, now let's just become Harrison. Yes, go on, go on.
So, now, even though it's a constitutional thing, those who plays within the political circles knows those things that the governor, you didn't need to mention it. You didn't need to re-echo it. You understand? So some of us, that amounts to another point we call greed. So for me, when you say party leader, it goes to show that you are not a godfather to your people. Of course, you may smile, but a godfather to the people, which means they all come and rally around you as their leader. And that, of course, you will also have, you'd have had in your own party. But here you were in your former party. You were not at home with your publicity secretary. You were not at home with your secretary, party secretary. You were not at home with your national party leader. At a point, I don't know, you know, there were rumors that
Let's not go on rumors.
No, he said that he spent so much money in trying to remove his national chairman. But whether that rumor was true or not, the state government coming to celebrate the attempted removal of a national chairman now gave flesh to the rumor that was going around or making around.
Okay.
So you understand the point I'm making. So at the point, one would expect that too much is given, much is expected. If you had issues, I say the media aid to the president coming to say the president attempted to settle them. It didn't work. I also recall that there was a point where the National Assembly also attempted to settle some issues, especially as it concerns the State Assembly, which really actually scattered, so to speak, the whole issue. They were cut short by restraining order. The second side, the Senate, came. They were restrained by court order. Governor's Forum attempted to speak. They were restrained. You understand?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I expect
so that it defied all efforts to resolve the issue.
And now you have gone. Who also says that there will not be issues in the People's Democratic Party? The point I'm making here is that in politics, you must learn to give and take.
Okay.
That is not to say at any point that you must give our collective patrimony to a collective or a negligible few.
All right, let me get Harrison in here. Some figures are being bandied as monies that have been spent. Obviously, perhaps the one we can easily relate with is the one used for purchase of phone on this side. And then on the other side, I need to get the reactions from
There are no issues there. Let me, before I go there, let me just remind my brother. You see, you said the suspended national chairman is a godfather. How best do you describe a godfather? That the man, the governor that you have, a sitting governor, you sat down and screaming out of your party primaries, and you went further the same day to do a press conference that you are the appeal court of APC. You are the Supreme Court of APC. It's not a godfather. You talk of betrayer, that Obaseki is betraying Oshobode. Who is betraying you? Go to history. How Obaseki Oshobode came to do government? He uses what to say it. But it was Godwin that brought him, let's go and do government in this state. Oshobode said with his mouth, the videos are there. Lucky we made you and someone who that brought Oshobode when he came in from Labour to AC to come and do government. Did you not betray them? A man that everything that he says is lies. You are telling me that
all
the statements that the Russian showman made there is there when the campaign starts. We are not doing any new jingle. We are using the jingle any before to begin to campaign. Let me go back to the question that you ask. That
figures being bandied,
These are all propagandas. Yes, from the governor on his own, as a sitting governor with a salary and what he get on monthly basis, can he pay for what he took away to look for 5 million? So why are we deceiving ourselves? He can pay for conveniently. So those are not the issues. The issue of 8 billion, they settled with 2 billion for social media, go to 6 billion. Where are the facts? Where was the money transferred from? You don't just come to the public and make statements, you don't have facts to back it up. You must even go look at your person. Where are the facts? If he spent 8 billion, he spent this, my brother, where are the facts? Which bank? Where were the money transferred? Who was the money given to? All these are propaganda. They are not crying away because they know that they have pushed the man to the wall. And they thought that was the end of the road. Because I was coming here, I have been a party person. But because of the injustice that we've done to this man, I took my decision. And this one is based on the performance of the government. I am not a conventional person. I kept saying it every day. When this fight started, every time I come here, I try to make peace. In the lab of the C4, I tell them, let us resolve this situation. This party will not become a victim. He said, no, nothing will happen. Let me see how they are going to come to the street of Benin and do campaign in the next election. For a man, the election between Obaseki and Oshobode, not even the person they are talking about. Because Oshobode have given so much up to a dead people. Oshobode have told us that this is the way things are supposed to be done. The same man, what you said was bad, that was not good. Overnight you have turned, and you are even doing worse. And Nene was a sitting governor, had issue with Derek Ibenedo. He knew the implication, there was a serious position. He knew the picture of the sitting governor. Moving to an opposition party, he allowed everything to resolve it, but he allowed the man to come. But because this one, they have been power draw.
You wake up and say, we have done it and nothing will happen. You said we are Peak Court, we are Supreme Court. And you told them, no, we have no choice. The amount was that the man will go to a low party so that they will share the vote, they will have advantage. If we go to the finish, it was 7. The people who give up problem in the field is PDP. We are you that give us problem in the field. And today, we have put on the NPC structure in the 1 of the 22 in the dossier to go and join the same PDP. Then before the people in the street, before the pensioners, before the drivers, the artisans, the people that they used to destroy with their whiskey will not come and vote for us. They let me see where they are going to do the vote. They already know what have happened to them because the who caused this problem, the national chair.
Okay.
You could not resolve the issue and you took side and you told them doing well. Where is it today now? Where is it?
All right, let me pass it there. Solomon, what are your perspectives on the key determinants on the 2020 Edo state governorship election in view of what has transpired? What are those key issues that would define the outcome of the polls?
You see, I'll talk about the conspiracy theory that the minority will continue to populate, direct, use the vast majority. And somebody say how that is possible. It's a few minority that are politicians knows the terrain. Now, when you talked about if at all there's any work, that was under the platform, that was under the agenda or the matter of the APC where the governor served, because the governor was brought in on the government of continuity. You know, I don't want to start towing my brother's line on rather than addressing the issues here. You go to Abuja and be talking. The election is not between Adams or Shomole for purpose of those at home hearing and watching us. It is not about an Adams or Shomole and Godwin Obaseki. It's about Edo states, the two political parties, APC and PDP, and their flag bearers. Mm. Today, I may not be able to tell you categorically.
Yeah. Who is representing who? Yeah. Yeah.
But as it were, it is between APC and PDP.
PDP.
And you know that slogan has not changed. The PDP share the money and all that.
No, the PDP part to the people. That's what we are aware of.
I said
let's stay on course, Solomon.
So for us, even in the D camp, we all are aware of our plate. Yeah, let's not mind space. You ask for the key determinant. The actions to your people. When people talk about work or works, I've asked here again and again. I'm asking outside Lucky Way, outside TV Road, outside the Oko Ebo Ilerin Ogba Road, now Texaimi Road, and then Ekewan Road that is ongoing. Which are the roads that Edo State government actually undertook, not using C4, that's a World Bank Intervention Program, CSDP, SOPADEC, NDDC, that is truly Edo State. And when you talk about TV Road, Texaimi Road, Ekewan Road, these were part of the 13 adjoining roads tied to the Edo Waterstone Project.
So it's an ongoing project,
yes.
Based on that so-called philosophy or ideology of continuity.
You know, when they laugh, we are in a media station, you can ask your PD to queue, you will go back, you will see it's there. Thank God, one of their clips they put on social media yesterday, they said, Clem Agba said, the project, Waterstone project, as it's going, that leave the Adams administration. And that's why when Adams was campaigning, because I hear him said we were going to use Adams' clip. He said it's a continuity, it's a continuum. Mm. You understand? Mm. So one would have expected to see massive, because when Adams was here, Edo State was like work sites. There were massive reconstructions, massive constructions, massive, you know, rehabilitations as it were. But we have not seen that. People say it doesn't make noise, it doesn't go out. Because this World Bank EU project, go and check the MOU. No state governments are allowed to do project monitoring. It is in their yearly work plan. I served in the World Bank board for 4 years. You understand in this state, so I understand how it works. You are not allowed as a governor to go inspect and carry chemicals. They feel it's a palliative, it's an intervention program for the downtrodden. So you can't go and show it on camera to the people, so that you are not asking for favor. If you are wanting to take people out of poverty, don't showcase their faces or what you are doing.
Yeah.
So that's why the governor cannot own it.
Okay.
Now, I've asked, where are those things that we can say? Oh, you go to schools and you paint the walls and you're putting your signboard and nobody is working. Somebody built the Red Roof Revolution. So these are the things that will determine the Edo 2020 gubernatorial election.
Okay.
And then people will speak. Let me tell you, there are sentiments. The Benin will say, oh, you may not understand, but I'll say it the way people will understand
it.
It's somebody that owns something. We will get there.
All right. Harrison, keep the time that.
Well, let me not, my brother is short of words. The same way I was.
No, yeah, I've been talking.
The same way I was when I was shanty campaigning for Buhari to come back for a second tenure. Let me tell you, my brother, we are in those states. We don't need to, we don't need to sing the praise. If you are ready, let me take you with my car. Let's go to Ogbe Stadium. You go and see where the world class, the standards of that place. I want you to go to technical school. You say C4 project. C4 project is a counterpart project, counterpart funding. If the state government does not pay their money, then you cannot start the project.
10%.
Excuse me, sir. 10%. What are you telling me? C4 project have been in existence before somebody ever came aboard. All those people, Shumura was going on. There is no adjoining street within the GRA. Excuse me. Calm down. Let's look at the issue. There is no road within the GRA that have made the tie. You used to go to Amagba. It was Morocco and Spain. Today is not tied to Amagba. Go to Tepikas on the school road. Go to PZ Road. Go to Sesevio. You are here telling me within the space of 3 years, go to Thomas, all the video of Babuja left in this states, they are now, people are not coming here to come and do video, to see the kind of standard. If you go to those people, civil service, you think you are in a hotel, and you are telling me adopt people on that day. And people was not bothered about politicians. No way. Those who are basically we are fighting with and show, but they are politicians. The voters, they are sitting there at home. And the same NPC people, for the very first time, a city government is moving, everybody is moving a mass. Just to tell you that we don't bother about money. I am a city council, I have not bought a car, I don't care. What I want to get is my salary. I came from an NGO background, I've been working over the years by NGO. You don't carry government money and share it. Even those in the government, they don't get the money. The commissioner live on their salary. That is the best. So the next dispensation, if you are doing a job, if I have a job where I'm earning 200,000 and they want to make me an SSA where I will get 150,000, I will not accept it. I will face my job. That is the direction.
Okay.
The government have designed it. Go to ICA, the industrial, go to a rural area, and go and see the innovation these governments have put in place. This is a government who have linked already to Kobaga Express Road. You are telling me the king get up by his work. What is work? We are going to assess the government in the space of 3 years, 3.5 years, and I spent Oshomole for 8 years. I mean, most of Oshomole did not work. But Oshomole by his use his own hand to destroy all the legacy he laid in the deficit. Because why? If we say this today and say another thing tomorrow.
Okay.
And all the right, we have to be consistent.
All right, gentlemen, thank you, gentlemen. We don't have much time. That's all we have time for today on TMI on Edo 2020. Of course, is a series in the build up to the 2020 Edo State Governorship election scheduled for September 19th, 2020. Big thanks, Comrade Solomon Idowu. Thank you for coming. Comrade Harrison is
coming. Thank you very much for coming.